Goeiedag studenten en baie baie welkom by die laaste les vir personeelopleiding N5. In this last video lesson, we will finish off with module 7 in your textbook, where we are still busy looking at planning and organizing a training presentation. In hierdie video gaan ons bietjie kyk hoe kan ons hierdie aanbiedinge beplan, hoe kan ons dit organiseer, and how can we make sure that it runs smoothly from the start right until the end. They normally say purpose, people gather for training with the purpose of learning and obtaining information. So daar's 'n spesifieke doel hoekom hulle opleiding gaan doen. The gathering can take place in many forms. Baie keer is dit 'n face-to-face contact sessie, baie keer is dit 'n video soos hierdie waar ons opleiding gaan deurgee. Sometimes it's in the form of a Skype or a Zoom session waar jy steeds face-to-face is maar via rekenaar of via 'n spesifieke software program. In most cases, there's a specific order that you have to follow these activities. En die eerste daarvan is jy moet 'n kennisgewing deurgee van opleiding. So when an individual has indicated that they want to attend a specific training course, they must get notice in a written format of when the course will take place, where it will take place, the time and the date, as well as any requirements that will be required of them to prepare for this case of the training course. In baie gevalle, wanneer hulle gaan moet vervoer word of hulle het op 'n verblyf nodig, gaan hierdie reëlings ook tydens die kennisgewing vir die werkers deurgegee word. Most cases, when you send this notice to your employees, you will also send them an agenda. An agenda is net 'n verkorte weergawe van die opleidingsprogram, waar jy vir die mense gaan sê, ja, in die volgende paar dae gaan ons die volgende onderwerp bespreek en ons gaan die volgende aktiwiteite doen. So these two documents are very, very important. On page 111, you'll see at the top, they give you an example of a notice for a training session or a meeting. En aan die onderkant is dit jou algehele agenda. Dit gee regtig net vir jou 'n idee van wat daarby ingesluit gaan word. On page 112, there are two additional documents that have to be planned. Die volgende een is 'n program. Your training program is very, very detailed. Dit sê vir jou presies wat ons gaan doen, wanneer ons dit gaan doen, en watter tyd ons gaan doen, which activities we will do, who are the presenters, what the topics will be that they'll be discussing, etc., etc. Vir alles wat 'n paar dae lange opleiding is, moet so 'n program redelik in detail gedoen word. Most employees will always ask when is tea time of wanneer is dit lunch break, sodat hulle kan gaan eet of kan gaan rook of oproepe maak. So this must all be included into your training program. Wat ook daar aangesluit moet word is wanneer daar bijvoorbeeld addisionele aktiwiteite na opleiding kursus gaan plaasvind, soos bijvoorbeeld 'n ete saam die aand of 'n award ceremony or whatever the case may be. So this must also then be included in the training program. Die laaste gedeelte wat ook ingesluit moet word is jou reaksievraelys, your reaction questionnaire. This is basically a document where you ask the employees to give you feedback, or the participants to give you feedback on the training course. Dit is gewone terugvoering wat hulle gee oor die venue, oor die materiaal wat hulle gekry het, oor die opleier self, whether the course actually met their objectives, of hulle dink die kursus het hulle gehelp. And you can also allow them to give you feedback in terms of what they think can be improved with this course. So hierdie reaksievraelys is 'n vorm van opleidingsevaluering wat ons nou gaan kyk in personeelopleiding N6. You can see an example of such a reaction questionnaire at the top of page 113 in the new textbook. So dis 'n baie belangrike gedeelte daai om seker te maak dat jy so 'n reaksievraelys het, want dit is deel van jou rekordhouding en dis jou terugvoering wat jy van jou deelnemers kry oor hoe hulle die kursus ervaar het. At the bottom of page 113, they talk about the facilities, equipment and materials. And in this instance, you just need to make sure that you have a venue. Of jy nou intern in jou eie besigheid venue gaan gebruik, of jy off-site gaan na 'n hotel of 'n gasthuis, it doesn't matter. You need to choose your venue that will be suitable for the sake of the training course. Maak seker daar's voldoende sitplekke, daar's voldoende beligting en air conditioning. Make sure that they can provide your refreshments, watertjies of snacks of middagete as dit van toepassing is. Make sure that you have all the equipment necessary, your extension cords, your projectors, your laptops, your materials that you also require, wat ons geleer het van in hoofstuk 5, the various training media. So all the methods and media and all the tools and materials and equipment that you need for that must be in place as part of the planning process. So voor jy met enige kursus kan begin, moet jy seker maak dat al die dinge in plek is and that you will be able to efficiently and effectively conduct training so dat jou leerdoelwitte bereik kan word en dat jou leerbehoeftes aangespreek kan word. Okay, so that is the end of personnel training in 5. I want to wish you luck with the exams. Baie sterkte. Ek glo dit sal goed gaan. Onthou, dis wat jy insit, wat jy gaan uitkry. Tot ons mekaar weer sien. Bye!